Well, joining me now from Scottsdale, Arizona is Kristin Bentz. She's a branding, media, and strategic advisor for luxury and consumer brands. Good to speak with you again, Kristin.
Thank you for having me.
Always. So, China is forecast to overtake Europe and the United States as the largest market for luxury goods in the coming years. I think they say in 2025. What accounts for this?
What accounts for this is just a thirst for luxury goods. And the Chinese consumer has that and more. And with the advent, unfortunately, of the pandemic that began in China, they were the first to go into lockdown. Chinese consumers were the first to come out. And so rotating that share of wallet out of luxury travel and into luxury goods was a big promoter of that.
Right. And, you know, they did come out of the pandemic really quickly, but retail is still struggling around the world. Not so for China anymore, right?
Not so for China anymore. Again, they were the main drivers of European luxury goods sales. In fact, I think in Guangzhou, the Hermes boutique there did $2.7 million in one day coming out of the pandemic. So they, I believe it was Shanghai and Beijing that were the most impressive in their luxury goods rebound.
Just staggering numbers. And in fact, this year, some of the big fashion labels, Gucci, Hermes, Chanel, raised their prices by as much as 20%, I read. And yet the demand remains high in China. Tell me, is that a strategy used by luxury labels? You know, make it even more unaffordable and the people will come.
Exactly. It seems kind of anathema, but yes, the more you want it, the more expensive it is, the more exclusive it is. It's, you know, that's the Hermes model that has worked forever. Bottega, in fact, just announced that they're taking their prices up in China. I believe it's like 4 to 12%. So that is actually a good sign for retail and a good sign for luxury when you can take your prices up. It means that the consumer and retail is rebounding. I know that sounds crazy, but that's kind of the way of the world when it comes to luxury goods.
So how do luxury brands cater to the Chinese market to really capitalize on this, you know, buying power that they have and this thirst for luxury goods?
Well, actually, China does what China does best, which is localization. So during the pandemic, China was really at the forefront with repatriating and keeping that local consumer local and buying luxury goods at a local level. You know, on top of that, brands that are you know, courting China like Prada, Celine, Hermes, they're courting the Gen Z generation. And they're using a lot of AI and a lot of different alternative methods in reaching their consumer, especially digitally.
Mm. Most of this luxury buying, though, I mean, the brands we're all talking about, they are imported brands. Why is there such a dearth of domestic luxury brands?
That's a great question. If I knew that answer, I probably wouldn't be here in Scottsdale. I'd be on an island somewhere. You know, I think China needs to innovate, and they have the consumer there. They have the thirst. They know what their consumer wants. But, you know, again, you never really, the grass is always greener, right? When it comes to shopping and branding, and one always wants what one can't have. So when you have something in a different country or something that's different to you, you covet that all the more. It's kind of the chicken and the egg when it comes to luxury goods, actually.
Kristin Bentz, it's always a pleasure to speak with you. Have a good weekend.
You too as well.